Dream Your Life is to visualize your dream, to really see it in your mind and set up a plan. And Live Your Dream is to go out and put that plan into action and do whatever it takes to get there. As long as you know what you're working towards every single day, then you know success is bound to come your way. My name is Matt Alonzo, and I'm a director. Dreams.
Kettle,
Matt Alonzo, amazing director.
Every time we do some shit, it go number one.
This has been in Matt from the beginning. This is what Matt loves to do. It's his art. It's his gift.
From an early age, I was exposed to the camera. In high school, it really became one of the main focuses of my life. Got out of high school and couldn't afford to go to a film school. But eventually, my parents knew that if I didn't go, I was probably destined for not a very successful life. During film school, I knew that this was the career path I was going to take.
You want to be a director?
Well, one of the dopest, the most freshest up-and-coming director. Look out for him.
Right now, we are headed over to the location for the Far East Movement music video. You know, shooting the Far East Movement video for like a G6 was a really big move for my career. The agent from ICM saw that music video, and that's what really turned him on to me. Within a short amount of time, I signed to ICM, and we're just kind of waiting for the right moment, for the right script. After film school, I was working for a small record company, directing and editing music videos for them. Something in my heart just told me it wasn't the place for me. I wasn't growing, so I decided just to leave. I went through a lot of struggles during those times. There was nights where I didn't know what I was going to eat. I didn't know how I was going to pay my rent. I didn't know how I was going to pay my car. I didn't know how I was going to keep my lights on. But with all those struggles, it really just made me a better man. There was never a question during any of those times if I was doing the right thing, or if, you know, I should go home, or if I should stop what I was doing. I always knew I was going to make it, and I was willing to do whatever it took.
Sometimes I have to just shake my head in disbelief, because it's amazing how all these things happen, and I'm definitely very thankful for everything. And at the same time, I do work my butt off, and I know that hard work pays off, but it's really about making sure that you can withstand the bad times to get here.
It's gonna be a beautiful day.
First shot, camera's here, wide shot establishing, slow motion, him coming down.
So, this is where all the magic goes down. I like to keep it simple, what I'm comfortable with, what works for me, and this is what works for me. Hours and hours, days go by, and I sit here. But luckily, I just got these packages in the mail, and these two packages here are magazine articles that I was featured in. First one is Creative Future magazine. So any reward like this, it's very humbling, and definitely trips me out a little bit. This one here is Carpinteria magazine. This is where I was born and raised. For them to put me in, you know, in a magazine, it's a great feeling. I hope that, you know, articles like this just give these kids some inspiration to keep pursuing their dreams. About 8 months ago, myself and my business partner, Michael Busalaki, decided it was time for us to leave Ski TV and see what else was out there. And it was definitely a scary time for us, just leaving, you know, our comfort zone, leaving the family that we had known for almost 4 years. But at the same time, we knew it was something that we needed to do. So we decided to leave and start our own company with another producer of ours named Kelvin Craver. Short time after that, we linked up with Happy Place. I'm really fortunate to have, you know, such a great team on my side, and it feels good right now. I feel like I'm in the best place I've ever been.
We got Tara right here, trying not to get on camera, but she's back here.
What is that?
Off me!
Well, there's a few things that I didn't anticipate coming with the job as being a director. First and foremost, really, is traveling. I didn't really see myself traveling, but I've been very fortunate to be able to travel all across the United States. This year, I went to Kuwait and Iraq with Exhibit to visit the troops, you know, just to go over there and share a smile and be able to talk to these guys. That was something that I'll never forget.
So the first step, you know, in getting music videos is I'll get a call from my agent who will have a record for me to listen to and write on. My creative partner and I will sit down and write out a treatment. Once it gets approved, then I have three producers right now, Michael Busalaki, Kelvin Craver, and Tara Razabi, and they pretty much take the steering wheel. My days usually consist of, you know, writing a shot list, and, you know, answering emails just to make sure that all the details are to my liking and make sure they go with the overall concept that we created. Days get really stressful, they get really long, but at the same time, you know, this is what I signed up for, this is what I love, and in the long run, it's all gonna pay off. Far East Movement music video today, featuring Ride Ride, Jello. Everybody's here. It's gonna be a big, big crew, big, big day. I'm excited, and let's rock and roll. Away from set, I'm really fun and I'm a little bit more lighthearted. Once I show up to set though, you know, for me, I feel like it's the Super Bowl. I feel like the day, you know, walking onto set is like walking onto the field. I played football my whole life, so I kind of go into the set with the same mentality. That day is means everything to me, so I want to make sure that I do it to the best of my ability.
Great energy already, crew's working hard.
When you actually see your idea come to life is one of the most amazing feelings and amazing things, you know, to be a part of.
It's the life we live, it's the life we chose, it's the life I love. Framed up here on this bottle. But we're just gonna focus on people's reactions.
Okay.
Michael Busolaki was a friend from film school. I've known him for about 8 years. Any videos that you've seen in the last three years have definitely, you know, had his fingerprint on them in some way or another. So, you know, he's an extremely big help to me, and he's a valuable piece on this team. My ultimate goals, you know, career-wise, is definitely to be a feature film director. That's something that I've wanted ever since I was a kid, and ever since I could remember, ever since holding that camera, that was something that I wanted to do. I wanted to make feature films. I wanted to make movies that are going to live on, you know, when I'm gone. And as a person, it's really just to grow and mature as a man, and also to have a family. That's something that's really important for me. I came from a great family structure. I think that's more important than, you know, the career aspect to me, is to be a good person, to be a good man, to be a good father, and to be a good husband. So, you know, those are things that I look forward to, and I'm working towards them every single day. To any kids out there who have a dream, one piece of advice I could give you is really just to visualize that dream and have that dream in your mind, and don't let anything stand in your way. Don't let anyone stand in your way. Just go out there and give it your all every single day, and know that there's going to be some downs with all the ups, and just expect those downs and really just push through those. As long as you keep, you know, your dream in the forefront of your mind and in your heart, then you're going to be okay. And other than that, I mean, just have some fun with life and go out there and get it.
I'm going to write it out. It's a wrap. It's over.